Gerald, the Boss Man Show with my man John Beckler. Have a great show for you today. Got four great coaches joining us on the show. Got the boss report, some emails. There's some good fun times for you guys here on the Boss Man Show. And gotta talk to you about it. We have our new website rolling out this week. So you can consume the show at BossmanRadioShow.com. John's been working on this website long and hard and tough. This will be better than the last website we had up there for you guys. You can interact with the show on the website. It'll be your base for all Boss Man Show fun, fundamentals, all things on the show right there. And guess what, people? You can listen to the show in the single segment form if you want to, or the hours via audio boom. But John's working on the site the most. I'm going to let John talk to you all about what he's done with the site. So, John, I'm going to let you give you this. The floor is yours, my brother. Talk to the people about the website, what they can expect, and what's coming with it down the road as we keep on going and build this Boss Man Show thing out more and more and more.
So, IT director. Let me put my IT director hat on, JR. So I can get this new website, get this new website up and rolling, so we can get these people off our backs, right? Get them off our backs. So we got,
man. What you see?
Basically, what's going to happen, JR, is same address, nothing changed on the website address, BossmanRadioShow.com. The only thing we changed is the formatting, and we're just going to freshen it up a little bit. It's going to be a lot cleaner. Going to have a lot more content on there, though, and that's what we were going for with this update. Refresh the website, put more content on there. You're going to have access to all the different platforms that we use, so you can listen to the show if you have all the apps, the audio boom, you know, all the different apps that JR rips off every week on the show. If you use one of those, you'll be able to access it through our website and listen to the show that way. You'll also be able to listen to the show as you used to on the website with just the player, you know, the straight-up player on the website. We're going to have all kinds of news, scores, you know, sports updates you can get directly on the website. So when you're at work, nothing plays. There's no autoplay. You don't have to worry about being muted or nothing like that. We're not going to put anything up there that's like getting to get you caught, you know, on the BossmanRadioShow.com on the low.
Exactly.
All right.
Exactly. We don't want that.
Nobody's going to come around and bust you that way. So if you want to hop on real quick, get scores, you can do that. We hooked up with FoxSports.com. So they're going to be on the website providing all that content for us. We're going to have some affiliate pages. We're going to obviously have ways that you can contact us and email the show to get on the email segment that we do each week. And we're going to add in maybe once in a while, JR, we haven't really discussed this too much. Maybe you and I might do, you know, a little blog post once in a while, or a little video blog, you know, a little vlog. Type thing, just to, you know, if something big pops off, you know, something big pops off you want to give your opinion on, or maybe I do, we can do something like that. But, you know, we're just freshening it up, JR, just freshening it up, more content, and I think it's going to be nice. I think it'll be nice for everybody.
Exactly. As we head into year six or seven, the boss was on the way, year six or seven, John. I don't know. I can't quite remember, but one of those years of the boss.
It's just like when you're when you're married or you've been in a relationship for a long time, people say, how long have you been together? And you got to think about it. That's the stage you and I are at, bro. We got to think about it now. Used to be like, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. You can rip that off. But now it's like, let me see here.
Yeah, like how many years we've been doing this? Since 2012. I can't do the math on that. I can't really count very well. I don't know if that's six or seven, because if I'm doing it this 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, I would seem like it's seven, but it may be six. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's on the map.
Yeah,
I
don't know. I always just do the six, six or seven, something like that. I just kind
of. Yeah, something like it. I know it's one of those two numbers. I'm not good at, quote, calendar math, okay? Not good at that, you know?
Yeah,
just noted.
But you're still better at math than people are at sending in emails to the show. Just know that.
Yes, indeed, yes. And I'm not gonna lie to you. TSU, I'm telling you, my classes that I was worst at, John, was accounting, college algebra, calculus, business finance, all those adding and subtracting crap, and economics too.
Oh God,
all that crap, macro, microeconomics. Yeah. I'm not good. I'm good at psychology, business management, HR, marketing. That's what I'm good at. All that number crap.
I hated economics. I hated macro. Microeconomics are the worst. My microeconomics course was taught by a Russian dude, and I, like, dude, straight off the boat, you could not understand a word this dude said, legit, and you're trying to learn economics from him. So that didn't go over very well.
Yeah, not at all. Like, yeah, see, my economics teacher, his real nice name was Dr. Weiss, a nice Jewish dude. He was a nice dude, but I don't know what he was talking about. Then I had stats. Yeah, I had stats.
Oh, that's
all
the worst.
Stats is standard deviations. All I remember was standard deviation. Besides, I don't know what the hell, I don't know nothing else. The learning curve, the standard deviation, then that one, Dr. Paratur, he's like, you gotta get a marker. Where's the marker? I have the marker.
Well, you're gonna have a problem with the website then, because when you have to log on, JR, you actually have to, you know, perform a statistical equation, and if you get it wrong, you're locked out. So you're actually SOL on that one, brother.
Yeah, I am screwed on that one for sure. I'll be turned over to my math whiz, JC Smith. He'll be able to get in because he is a math wizard. He is. He's the cheapest man I know. He loves to value money. I know that about JC Smith. He loves to value money. He's a very cheap man. You know, he knows how to calculate a coupon down to the taxes, John.
The line between cheap and smart is very, very thin.
Exactly. Now, John, speaking of our apps, man, like, we got you, the Free Mobile Apps people. We got you on Audio Boom. We got you on CastBox, Deezer, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Stitcher Radio, TuneIn, Google Play Music, John. Like, for those who say they can't find the show, I can't understand it, John, because we have you on all these Free Mobile Apps. And plus, we're in multiple podcast directories, like a cast. We're on podcast.com, Overcast, we iTunes. Like, I don't understand, John, when I hear from people, I can't find the show. What are you doing? You can't find the show. It's available anywhere you want to get it, on your phone, tablet, computer, or anything you use. You can have the show. Just find it. Bossman Show.
They must be looking on the wrong internet.
Well, based on the emails we get, might be the wrong internet. Maybe the wrong internet as well. Like we got you covered.
There's only one, right?
I thought it was.
As far as I know.
I thought it was. What's good about the website, John, and the apps is this, John, people. Like, you get, and if you want it on an app, you can get it in an hour form. You want the single segment, go to the website. So if you got a certain guest you want to hear, like, you say if you want to hear from, you know, Ron Sanchez of Charlotte, you can just go check his interview out. Listen to Joe Dooley, East Carolina. This pick up his Joe Dooley. Hit him up. So it's like this, people. So you have to do this, people. Put some effort into it. It's all good. Put some effort into it. Put your back into it. It's all good. So what I'm trying to say to y'all is this. When the show is posted, when you get the show sealed on the website, it's already on the apps too. Take your pick. If you're in your car, pull it up, listen to it. Subscribe to the shows on these apps as well. So subscribe to the YouTube page. Also on Spreaker as well. Like, John, I just never thought when we started the show in 2012 that we'll be on so many apps, syndicated, rather, with deals, these people, where they actually want to play our show. They couldn't meet me to play our show. Not the other way around.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, we talked about it a couple times this year on air. And it's been fun. You know, it's been really fun. It's been fun to watch the show grow. And, you know, this year we're really kind of looking to take that next step, you know, and it's already starting to happen. So, you know, obviously it doesn't happen without the support of the listeners and the people that have been there. I'm sure there's a lot of people. I know there's a lot of people that have been there since day one listening. And to all the new folks that are coming on board, we appreciate you checking us out. And we're hopeful that you'll stick with us.
Yes, indeed. Well, folks, this is the Bossman Show. This week we got a show open for you coming up. We got some great games for you. We got four good coaches, E-Myth, Boss Support, and JC Smith coming for you today on today's show. This is JR and John. We ready to go, people. About to go down. Holler at us. Let's go. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-6079. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
A gorgeous tan from Suntan City gives you an inner glow that relights the fire when you run into your first crush.
Vicky, who is that?
An old boyfriend.
Lucky you just tanned at Suntan City.
Lucky he's single. We're doing lunch tomorrow.
Won't be single for long then.
During Tour of the City, try all five tans, including spray tan, for just $4.99. Restrictions may apply. Click to buy now.
Hip hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you two discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. True Speech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it, get it.
Show. We're joined by Ron Sanchez, coach of your Charlotte 49ers over there in Charlotte, North Carolina, up the road from here. Coach Sanchez is hustling, bust about off there. Coach, man, how's it going today, man?
Everything is going okay, you know. Long day, a lot of work being done after the evaluation weekend, and, you know, kind of moving along.
I hear that, Coach. Well, congrats on naming the coach at Charlotte. Coach, it's a great job over there in Charlotte. You're a nice city. So what does it mean for you to get the job at Charlotte over there? And also, Coach, you got a good community to build around and put a stamp on with you and your team. So how are all those factors feel for you, Coach, going over there to coach the 49ers going forward, man?
Hey, you know, I'm genuinely excited about it. I'm thrilled to have this opportunity. I think it's an amazing city. I think that the fan base here is going to be very supportive. And I'm genuinely just thrilled to show up to work every day.
Well, I hear that, Coach. And you know what, Coach? You said it's a great community, great fan base, with a lot of history about Charlotte as well. So along with that, what about the administration and just the opportunity as a whole made you decide, hey, let me – this is my time to make this jump from give me my own head coaching gig and leave from being an assistant at Virginia?
Yeah. You know, when I talked to Mike Hill, I really believed in the vision that he had for the institution, you know, overall for the athletic department, but, you know, primarily for the basketball program. I think he really understood where the program was and was going to be very supportive and very direct as to the direction that he wants the program to go in. And I was thankful that he thought that I was the guy to have arms with and join in with to try to make that change and to try to make things happen.
And, Coach, what do you feel like would be the biggest adjustment for you moving that one chair over? I know being an assistant, you don't have to deal with all the head coach pressure. You use the most – all the players love you because you're not the one that's giving out minutes. You're working them out. Yeah. So that's the biggest adjustment would be for you, Coach, going over that one seat to be the head man now here in Charlotte.
Oh, man, it's been hard already. I got to tell you the truth, you know, because I have gone from being the, you know, kind of the favorite guy, the guy that guys could come and complain to about the head coach to – all of a sudden, you know, pushing down some disciplinary actions on guys and the team. So it's been a little different already, you know. But at the end of the day, as long as you can push these kids hard while they're on the floor and then, you know, really have a genuine relationship once they're off the floor, I think everything works out. You know, I've been known as, I guess, a quote-unquote player's coach, you know, because I, you know, tend to have a pretty good relationship with the guys. And now it is. It's a little different, man. You know, everybody's asking me a lot of questions, and I got to come up with answers, not suggestions. So, you know, it's a big change for me.
Exactly. And I feel like, Coach, for you coming from Virginia, so on Tony Bennett's program and all that staff, man, the guys already, you have instant credibility with the guys in the locker room because, hey, you came from a winning program, a winning background, a winning pedigree, and when you say something, it's probably where it needs to be. It's going to get us to where we want to be as a program.
No, exactly. And, you know, I don't know. You know, these kids are still 18, 20-year-olds, you know, and they still think they know more than anyone else. That's just that's just what it is. You know, we got to do the best job that we can in showing them that this is a process. You know, when we have to fall in love with the journey and fall in love with hard work, and you know that it's not sexy and cute and easy. That it's just genuine hard work. You know, and I give them credit because, you know, my entire time here thus far that we've been on the floor together, they have worked hard. So I think they are kind of understanding what it takes, and I do think that they are willing to do the work.
Now, Coach, often you're able to get on the floor with your guys as a new head coach. Does the rules kind of change? Is it the same kind of rules they have, whether you're sitting head coach or you new? How much are you able to get on the court with your guys and see kind of what you have as you want to recruit and build your roster out?
Yeah, no, I mean, it's the same. It's the same. You know, we get 2 hours a week with them right now, so we try to spread out as much as we can. Sometimes, you know, three 40-minute workouts. You know, if we end up, you know, doing a little more one day, maybe one workout would be 30 minutes. But at the end of the day, just spending time with them, you know, on the basketball court is where they are most comfortable. And, you know, that's been what we have been doing as staff.
And I hear that, Coach. We've got Ron Sanchez here, the Bossman Show, Charlotte Fornals head coach. And, Coach, recruiting-wise, Coach, what kind of guys do you want to willing to target to bring to your program? Are you trying to go for high school freshmen, JUCO guys, transfer a little bit of all three?
You know, it's hard to say I'm only going to do one thing or the other because, you know, different opportunities present themselves nowadays, especially with, you know, the number of transfers that have come along. You know, I would like to bring in some guys that have, you know, some experience if possible, you know, whether it's playing a lot of minutes and being really good players in high school, or guys that, you know, maybe played a year or two in college and, you know, maybe looking for a new home. But guys that understand, again, it's all about the understanding of the hard work. For me, it's, you know, bringing a group of guys in that have tremendous character on the floor and also, you know, tremendous character off the court. So, you know, those keys are going to probably be more important than where they come from as far as JUCO, high school, or transfers.
And now, Coach, when people watch you guys play this year, what is your vision of how you guys want to play as a roster? You really don't know yet because you don't know who you're going to bring in the summertime. And second part of the question is, Coach, when somebody watches your team play, what do you want them to take away from seeing your guys play every night out there representing the 49ers of Charlotte?
I want them to see that this team will have an identity, you know, and that identity is going to be fostered, you know, from now to the first time that we get on the floor. But they will know what's going to be important to the staff and the team when they watch us play. You know, they're going to say, this is a team that does, you know, this and this and this well, you know, regardless of the opponent, you know, regardless of the situations. I do want to have a team that has a genuine identity when teams watch them play.
Now, Coach, looking at non-conference scheduling, I know a lot of it's probably already done for you right now. So, as you look forward, you know, you're going to a good conference here for scheduling games. Are you going to look for two-for-ones or guarantee games, getting maybe how major to come play you at your place? So, how do you look for scheduling going forward? Are you one of the guys who want to have a hard schedule leading to conference play? Or do you want to kind of give them some wins here or there to get them to build up that confidence there?
You know, I think it's a balance of it all. You know, right now, the schedule that I have is a schedule that I've inherited. You know, this was already set in place prior to me being here for the last, you know, 2.5 weeks. So, and to be completely transparent, I have not paid that all that much attention. It's kind of irrelevant to where we are right now. I mean, the schedule is what it is, and we just got to show up and play. But I'm hoping to challenge the guys. My goal is to make sure that we improve, you know, after every single contest. So, you know, I'm hoping that I can do that through some, you know, lessons playing against some pretty good opponents and some pretty good coaches.
Now, Coach, I love to get the background of guys' stories and who's helped them, you know, get to where they're at today. So, Coach, for you personally and professionally, who have been some coaches and individuals in your life that you love to shout out and give a little tidbit about who's helped you get to the point you are today as a head coach of the Charlotte 49ers going forward?
Yeah. Man, I'm the product of a whole lot of hands, man. I was raised by a village, you know, a village of coaches, from my college coach, you know, to the guys that I ended up working for, you know, from Indiana to Washington State to Virginia. You know, I've had a lot of help in my journey, particularly, you know, the Bennett family, from Kathy Bennett, who was the head coach at IU women's basketball, so obviously Tony and his father, Dick, and, you know, Mike Davis at Indiana, John Treloar, who was, you know, Mike Davis's assistant at Indiana. You know, I'm a product of a lot of people, man. If you ask me to shout out all the people that have helped me out, man, I'll probably be on the phone for a long time.
Hey, I hear you, Coach. Hey, some of them coaches you just named have been on the show, and I love talking to these guys on the show. Some of these guys you mentioned, man, great company. You come from a great tree of people. I can see it right now, a great tree of people.
Thank you.
Now, Coach, that's what I got for you. Kind of talk about pre-show here. Talk to about what is your typical day like. I know you got to work out probably, to call recruits, staff meetings, talk to the boosters, the university people, and the administrators. So talk to us. What's kind of your typical day, Coach? Like, give us a little insight into what your day sounds like each day.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Our guys work out pretty early in the morning. You know, they lift weights, you know, around 6 a.m. And the days that I'm around and my schedule allows, I like to kind of sneak in there if I can. I try not to get involved, but just to pick my head in the gym. This is how I start my mornings. And, you know, if I can, and, you know, the schedule allows, I like to get a little sweated myself, you know, to kind of just get my day started, you know, a good cup of coffee, a little personal time to gather my thoughts, and then I'm going to tackle work day, you know, whether it's recruiting calls, from, you know, I've duties with the administration, you know, always meet about schedule for the future, and, you know, kind of just things that are laid on your desk on a daily basis, you know. So that's kind of my typical. But the one thing that I have to do every morning is, you know, obviously my family is not here in Charlotte yet, so I like to call my kids, you know, before they head out to school. That's one thing that I can't miss. And, you know, they usually around 7:45 or 8 o'clock in the morning, I try to get my kids on the phone before I start my day to remind me, you know, why it is that I get up every day.
I hear that, Coach. That daily vitamin is my father would always call it. You need it every day to get your day started right there. That's something that I do as well here in radio. I got to talk to people to get my day just right, Coach. So I'm right there with you, man.
Exactly. Without those things, man, then we, for some reason, we feel like we're off. We're just a little off, so.
Yes, indeed. Well, Coach Rosanchez, thanks for coming on the show, Coach. You know, my dad's Dominican, so I guess I got a lot of love for you, too. My dad's Dominican,
so
definitely there's a connection there because, like, yeah, so my dad is. So, you know, I got to make sure my lineage there now. So I got to get you on the show because of that, Coach, for sure.
How is your Spanish? That's the real question. If your Spanish is just okay, you know, then we're gonna have to fix that.
It got to be fixed, Coach. It got to be fixed.
Oh, it sounds great.
Look,
man,
here.
Listen,
now,
thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
Hey, Coach, where you go? Now, I have the fast tongue, though. I have to work on the actual content, what's coming out.
Oh, hey, the fast tongue is genetic. It just comes with the territory. You can't avoid it. You know, it just comes
with
indeed.
It. Yeah. Coach, thank you again for your time, Coach. We got to do this again real soon. Have a great day, man.
You got it, my man. You got it. Have a blessed one.
All your photo, video, and voiceover needs, check out the fine folks at Blu Ray Productions. They will take good care of you. If you don't believe me, you can see for yourself. Check out their work at blueberryproductions.tv, the Facebook page, Blueberry Productions, also a Vimeo page, a YouTube page, and it's Blueberry, BlueBerry Prod on Twitter. Check them out today. Blueberry Productions, Great people, great work, great service.
Fantasy football season is fast approaching, and if you're looking for an edge this season, you need to contact the guys at Draft Day Consultants. The concept is a simple one. Draft Day Consultants takes your requests and connects you with one of their trusted analysts, who then guide you through your draft. Whether you just need a sounding board on decisions, or if you need them to conduct your entire draft, Draft Day Consultants has you covered. Every one of their consultants has a proven track record of success and have conducted hundreds, even thousands of mock drafts. Thanks to this year-round research and analysis, the guys at DDC have an unmatched understanding of player values. So gain an edge on your league mates this season by hitting up DraftDayConsultants.com. That's www.DraftDayConsultants.com. Now get after it, fantasy footballers.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man JC, the host with the most, baby, and it goes down each and every Saturday night right here in the city of Memphis. That's right, y'all. It goes down at Clicks Sports Bar Memphis, baby, 3705 Malco Way, Memphis, Tennessee, 38125. Come out and join us, the Three Kings, each and every Saturday night for the livest karaoke in the city. Everybody gets in free till 10 p.m., only $5 after. Great food. We got drink specials. We got all kind of games, man. We got the pool tables popping. Whatever you want, we got you, man. Come on out. Have a good time with us each and every Saturday night. That's Clicks Sports Bar, Memphis.
Mike Wilmer.
Time for this week's listener emails with John and myself, John Beckler. Are you ready for this week's batch of listener foolishness?
I can only imagine what's about to come my way.
Brother, I know we're about to get emails. It's been a while now. Have you recovered from the last batch? Or are you wiped clean now? Are you pure now?
Well, I don't think I've ever been pure over the course of the last, you know, what are we on now? 6 or 7 years? Did we determine?
We still don't know, brother.
Ever since I started doing the boss report of the emails, I don't know that I've ever been pure. That's kind of a stretch. So I am ready to go through these. You know, I guess I'm as close as I can be to being pure as far as the emails are concerned.
Well, hi, folks, and keep the word pure in your mind. You're about to hear it again real soon, John. In this first email, there is addressed to get this. Purified D. Walker and Toshiba Ennis. Gentlemen, spelled with a J-I-E-N-T-I-L-M-A-N. Eyes went, oh my God, to high skill reunion. And my high skill sweetheart, high school sweetheart, okay. We hatch a little bit of something in the pest. We part ways of the money and sex. He means money and sex. Eyes have a soft, tough spot for high skill, sweetheart. Feel inside fieldlings. Purblown, not problem, but purblown. His sweetheart is fat. Oh, God. I leak, no, body and head, lard good. Oh, my God. Face cut things, L is what, warm, question mark. You know, I know, who know. Filled it my taxes today. You're late, my man. When the refund coming. Love the soul. Thanks. Pablo Rob in the Arizona Deli. John, have fun.
Oh, this is one of those ones that, like, you have to see it to believe it. Because the way that Pablo is spelling some of this stuff is just wow. But he does have a legit problem, JR. He went back to his high school reunion and he saw his high school sweetheart. They had a little something in the past. They parted ways over money and sex, correct?
Yes.
He's always had a soft spot for his high school sweetheart. He feels feelings inside, right, JR? He's got some feelings for this girl. The problem, Pablo, is the sweetheart is fat now. That's the best one, though. He spelled it P-H-J-C. So, like, was she not fat before? Like, okay. So she's fat now. Okay. And he says, I leak gnaw. Does that mean?
I'm like gnaw.
Right? Okay. I'm like gnaw. Body and head large. Right. Oh, man. I don't know. Like, I don't know what the problem is, Pablo. Like, if you're. Are you twisted because you have feelings for her, but she don't look the same? Is that what's going on here?
I think so.
So, listen, man, you know, the heart wants what the heart wants. Sometimes you've got to look past your, you know, what your quote-unquote type is in a woman, you know? Maybe you like, you know, women that are a little bit more athletic, a little bit more in shape. Some guys like a little bit, you know, a little bit more a bigger woman, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just got to look past that. If you have feelings for somebody, you got to make a decision. Do your feelings for that person supersede their outward looks? Or are you more concerned with, you know, the way she looks? And then you don't really care how she makes you feel. You know, might be a little bit superficial. Just going to have to figure that one out for yourself, Pablo. You have to look deep inside for your feelings. Your fieldlings, I should say. I just gotta get back to these names too, because we didn't touch on those, JR.
Yes.
Purified D. Walker. Okay. So that's you. What is that? Like Purified Delaney Walker? Is that what he's trying to say?
I don't know who that is. Like, what? And Purified D. Walker.
He's calling me Toshiba Innes. When the hell did I turn out to be a TV? Like, what the? I don't even know, bro. I don't even know. But Pablo, we enjoy that you enjoy the show. You know, that's cool. We're down with that for sure. I mean, we're happy to help you out. I would say, though, like JR, you know, if she's not, listen, this is going to sound really bad, okay? But ladies, turn off your ears for a minute. This is to all the guys out there. Pablo, if she's not like super hit in the face and you love her, like you feel like this might be the girl for you, like you guys, you know, jive mentally, maybe that's the one, bro, you know? Maybe that's the one. You never know. Maybe you hook up with this girl, you get married, she starts to lose a little bit of weight, turns into a knockout. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just got to roll the bones, Pablo.
Exactly.
Hopefully I didn't offend anyone when I said that.
I hope not. I'll hear about it on Monday. If you did, I'll hear about it on Monday.
These days, you never know, bro. You never know. Oh, anyway, JR, let's get into our second email before I get myself in any more trouble. This one, JR, is for you, and it's coming to us from Kenny Williams at Strike Pair Center. Okay? I have no idea what the hell that is.
He's a strike and spare center, my man, maybe?
Maybe so. I don't know. We'll find out in a minute. So, JR, Kenny Williams says, General and Tree.
Jesus.
Right then. I'm unfit by what's developed on my soap media. One no lesser than three Cajuns, women's I deal with in the sky ago, are arising on soap media. What Ezra's purpose for arising on media? Not cool with M no mo. Not cool as not cool. Don't forget, not cool. Process and action, same. Any Orions on it? JR, that's coming from Kenny Williams at Strike Pair Center.
Kenny, my man, I think you're unfit in life, my man. That's what I think. You're up in the life, my man. Like, it's called social media, not quote soap media. I don't get that. John, I think I get what he's saying. On no less than three occasions, he went with one no lesser than three Cajuns.
Like, I'm sorry, but that's not spell check, bro. That is not spell check.
Like, on less than three occasions, but you got on no lesser than three Cajuns. Wow. Woman's ideal when in the sky go arising. So we deal with in the past coming on your social media. I got you. What's Ezra? I don't know. Who's Ezra? A woman? Or a man? A friend? I don't know what it is. Propose for arousal. Not cool with them no more. Yeah, that happens to me too, brother. It happens to me as well. Not cool, not cool. Don't forget, not cool. Process extra. Any, I guess, opinions, I guess, John, or Orion's? Kenny, to the point here. Yes, people, I had it happen to me before on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. People who I don't like, we kind of parted ways in a bad fashion, will pop back up on you. And like, oh, yeah, what's up, boss? Nah, we're not cool, good. I'm about to go to hell. It happens, Kenny. Don't let it get to you. Block, ignore, block, ignore. Or let them in. Let them see how you're doing well, because your success is their worst nightmare. So, Kenny, it's truly on you, my brother, on how you handle the situation, my man. It's truly on you, Kenny. But, yes, that his line, John, of one less than three Cajuns. Oh, no less than three Cajuns. Oh, my God. Maybe the worst line ever in the email, maybe.
I like how he says, not cool with them no more. Not cool is not cool. Don't forget, not cool.
Exactly.
Okay, so what you're saying is it's not cool, right?
Exactly. Like, he's saying it 3 times in a row.
Got it. Copy that, Ghost Rider.
Exactly. Man, oh, man. Johnny, any more on the strike at the Pear Center, maybe? The strike's Pear Center on Kenny? Is that the ball alley he's talking about, probably?
I was thinking about that while you were reading through it, and I don't really know what the heck that is. I mean, like you said, it could be strike and spare center, it could be a bowling alley, but I don't really have anything on that one, man. Strike Pear Center, it's all spelled correctly too, so as far as we know, he's just rolling at some place that's called Strike Pear Center.
Exactly. Yeah, Kenny, yeah, your email, brother, do better next time, my man. Do better next time, please. This email, oh my God, John, here we go. Dominique Arrowbat and Rashad Cook. I have some coupons at Captain D's. It's just one per visit. Whose rule is that? Why is that? I have 5 I want to use to feed my family. Feed your family? I got a family to feed. This one really wants to use is the fish and fries one. Do you, Mink, Weather, can use to sub in off the beach grilled fish for fried fish on coupon? Is there a change or nah? Ta-da sign, right? I'm paranoid, I'm tripping. That's ta-da sign, ain't it? Mace up and floss with me. That's Kyle in Georgia, John.
He answered all his own questions at the end when he said, I'm paranoid and I'm tripping. Yeah, that's right. I love it. If everybody that emails us could at the end just say what you're on, that would be like even that would just help us out that much more.
Exactly.
Like if you say drunk, just say drunk or high on weed or painkillers, whatever. Just say what you're high on. That'll help us decipher your email. Listen, I mean, if you've got a coupon, whether it be to Captain D's or anywhere else, you've got to abide by the rules that apply to that coupon. So if it says, you know, one per customer, valid only, you know, this time through this time, then that's what it is, man. You can't take, you know, 15 $5 coupons up to the store and expect to get, you know, 15 $5 off. So you get your stuff for free. That's not how the coupon works. That's not what they're going for. The coupon is to bring you into the location so that you purchase something, and then they give you a discount for coming in. That's the whole idea there, Kyle, is that they're, you know, trying to incentivize you to come into their location. So they're foregoing a certain portion of their profit to incentivize you to come into their location. So they're not going to give you anything for free. So you're asking, whose rule is that? That's the company's rule. Why is that? Well, I just explained that to you. They're trying to incentivize you into the store. I understand that you got a family to feed. You know, everybody's got, you know, mouths to feed at home, whether it's themselves or you know, themselves and kids, whatever. We're looking for a little bit of a discount here or there. But if you're going to play the coupon game, Kyle, you got to play it right, man. You cannot come sideways in the coupon game. I don't know if you've ever seen some of these ladies at the supermarket with the coupon books.
I have.
You don't want to come sideways to one of those ladies, man. You try to get over on the coupon crowd, they will coupon you to death, brother. They will coupon you to death. You got up the strict rules in the coupon game, man. So, Kyle, if you want to roll down that path, you want to become a couponer, a hardcore couponer, you're going to have to get off the whatever you're on that's making you trip and making you paranoid, and you got to come correct, brother.
Ta-da, son. I'm paranoid. I'm tripping. Can't stop. Me stiffing, got my hand. Top dollar sign, man. He just top dollar sign songs when you email the show.
And I love how he sells us, like, the one I really want to use is the fish and fries coupon. Like, I really want to use that one, guys. Like, okay. Then go use it, bro. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Like, but you can't use 15 of them. I'm sorry. Like, if it's buy one, get one, you know, free coupon. You can't, like, you know, buy one and then get, like, 15 free. It's just like, that's what it is, bro. You know?
Exactly. Oh my God. So, John, you're in the email segment. What is your take on this email segment, my good brother?
Well, let's go backwards here. So, Kyle actually had a nice thing where he told us that he was tripping, which helped us, you know, so then we could say, okay, now we know why the previous, you know, 15 sentences were so whacked out. He was tripping. Okay. Makes sense. And then we had Kenny at Strike Pair Center. We have no idea where that's at. He has some issues with his social media. You know, I got to give it today out of the three. Let's see here. Who else did we have? Oh, that's right. We have Pablo.
Oh, yeah, Pablo.
I'm giving it to Kyle in Georgia because he was nice enough to tell us that he was tripping. And we were able to help him much more thoroughly because we knew his state of mind. That's why I'm giving it to Kyle today.
Exactly. I'm with you. Kyle and George, you're our winner. Hey, folks, email the show, holla. Spreadshow.com is holla. Spreadshow.com, hit us up. We'll answer emails best we can. We choose to read your email on our email segments, folks. That's emails. We out. Back in the JR the Boss Man show. Got a buddy of mine on the line. He's moved on up to Missouri State, the Bears, Springfield, Missouri. My man, Daniel Ford, Coach Ford, back in the Valley, man. How I feel, buddy?
Hey, man, feels good. It feels good to be back in the Valley. Great situation here at Missouri State. And we really enjoyed our time at Tennessee State. And we have so much respect and admiration for everyone there. And we just thought it was time to move on, but we're excited for the challenge that awaits us.
Well, Coach, I'm going to tell you this on the air right here. I'm going to miss you. I hate that you're gone, but I knew that this day would come. But John, tell you that I'm sad for the school and the guys you left behind, but I know it's good for you, man. I'm glad we're friends. I'm glad I got to meet you and got to know you personally. I'm looking forward to the success of Missouri State, man.
I appreciate it, man. It was, you know, it was not an easy decision at all, but it was one of those decisions that had to be made, and we'll obviously miss Tennessee State, we'll miss Nashville, and we're looking forward to what, you know, what God has in store for us moving forward.
You got there, right, Coach? I know it's hard because you love your church in Nashville. It's good. Talk about your church and what that meant to you and your church family and what that did for you and your family in your time in Nashville.
You know, for sure. Our faith, it just grew. That was the first time I felt like we were able to establish some roots for an extended time together as a family, our wife and obviously our children. So we took advantage of that. And we attended church with people who, number one, were all about, you know, Jesus and all about doing what the Bible said. And we kind of tried to instill that into our children. We found out that they were really growing, and that was something that was important to us. And I think, you know, Nashville as a whole kind of has a lot of churches like that. And And I think it was our time living in the Bible Belt. And we could really tell that, it had an impact on the city. You know, you typically don't hear about a lot of things going bad. And that's what we went through the other day. They had a really bad tragedy. But it's normally been a pretty place. And I think, you know, all the people around there that are involved in so many churches are really why.
You got there right, Coach. And, Coach, I want to ask you, you're back in the Valley, back in your roots. So what does this mean to you to get this opportunity to go to the Valley? Say, we'll call it a great job in the Valley Winter Conference. But you can definitely do things if you have the right players and right staff around. So how does this, what does this mean for this staff in this community of Springfield and add what you learned in Nashville with you and your wife and take it up to Springfield and put it on that community up there?
You know, it means a lot. It means a lot because, number one, my wife and I, we feel like this is a great place to raise our family. You know, the town is all about the Bears and the university, and I think that'll be a different experience for our family. We had a great time in Nashville, but you know, when you're involved in the sports world in Nashville, you're kind of sharing spotlight with so many other teams. But here, the university is particularly in town, so we felt like that was going to be a really good experience for our family. And we've already been helped out tremendously, literally in every aspect of our personal lives. So we're really looking forward to that. And from a basketball standpoint, we just feel like we have everything that we need in order to try to compete for championships and hopefully take our place in the NCAA tournament where anything can happen. And that's going to be our goal every time we go out on the practice floor is to try to do our best in giving back from an effort standpoint, an execution standpoint, just giving back to all the things that have been given to us here for our program.
So, Coach, a lot of times, you know, I'm speculating here, but when a man like yourself looks at a new coaching opportunity, there's got to be a lot of things that go through his mind. And one of those, I would assume, is probably what the administration is like at the new location. So what is it about the administration that you saw being a good fit for you, being people that you wanted to work with and kind of take that next step in your career? What is it about them that made you feel comfortable in that situation? Because that's one of the big, probably the strongest relationships you've got to have is with that administration, if I'm not mistaken.
For sure. And you know, I was fortunate because my administration at Tennessee State, my athletic director, Teresa Phipps, and President Glover, they were all about providing me the things that they felt, you know, I should have in order to attain the goals that they had set for me. And my relationship with them was really, really good. So I kind of knew I could catch early on if I wasn't going to be able to have a relationship with the new administration throughout the process, if my communication with them was not as, you know, good as it was my previous. So once the process started and the communication was really good and I found out that they were also, you know, basketball people and things of that nature, that really helped. I think a lot of times if you get administration that understands what it takes to win and they're willing to do those things, that right there is a big reason why you should probably take a dive. And it didn't take 5 minutes for me to realize that they were going to say, hey, we're going to give you whatever you think you need to obtain the goals that we have. And that's what I was used to. And so on top of that, my athletic director here, Kyle Motes, he's had some experience. He's worked with University of Kentucky basketball, University of Louisville basketball. So he's a basketball guy. And anytime you can get with basketball people as a basketball coach, that's pretty exciting. So I've had the luxury of working for a former basketball coach at Tennessee State and now a former basketball administrator here at Missouri State. So it's a really good fit for me.
And, Coach, you're also in a basketball conference because you don't have to worry about so much football, per se, in the Missouri Valley Conference. It's more about basketball, the Valley being where it is. So going from the OVC to the MVC, what do you think the biggest adjustment for you personally as a coach and how you build your roster going forward?
You know, that's a great point. It is a basketball league, and that was something else that attracted me to it. You know, I played in the Valley. I've coached in the Valley at two different institutions. So I'm very familiar with what it takes to win in this league in terms of recruiting and development of a program and your scheme and things like that. So that's definitely something that weighed heavily on me, and it means a lot. You know, it means a lot that will go into a really good basketball venues that have great home court advantages with some really, really good coaches. You know, you look throughout college basketball, and there's so many of the best coaches who have spent some time in the Missouri Valley, whether it was back when they were an assistant coach or even some head coaches who have won here and moved on. So it's just such a a great, well-respected basketball conference. It's one of the oldest conferences in the country, and I'm really looking forward to the challenge. It will be a different ballgame than the OVC. I think the OVC is a fantastic basketball conference as well, but this league, the coaches are a little bit more veteran coaches in this league, and the programs they have just a few more resources, and the level of history that each program has in this league is hard to match, not only for the Ohio Valley, but a lot of other conferences in the country.
So, Coach, looking at the new program from a recruiting standpoint, you know, JR and I know, you know, what kind of guys you look on the court, but maybe some of our listeners, you know, might be familiarizing themselves with you. What are you looking for in guys on the court and off the court to bring into the program? Are you looking for guys, high school freshmen, JUCO guys, transfers, mixture of all these types of players?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the recruiting has evolved. It's changed. So we got to be on top of the way it is now. We got to try to be ahead of the curve. We can't try to reinvent the wheel. We will recruit all different levels, high school, number one, number two, the joint transfers, number three, junior college, and also number four, international. So we're not going to limit ourselves at all, even with the fifth-year transfers. So it's going to be one of those type of situations where it changes every day. Obviously, we make really, really hard push for four-year kids, the high school kids, especially in-state. We got St. Louis area, Kansas City area. But also, we're going to try to get into Texas, Dallas and Houston, as well as maybe even the West Coast. There's so many untapped players out there on the West Coast that we're going to try to get into. And then we'll also work some Midwest states like Minnesota and see if we can put together, you know, with a group of players here. We always pay attention to talent level number one. And then obviously their character comes into play right after that. We're looking for kids that want to be utilized the way that we have the vision for them. And if we can do that, then we feel like we can put a roster together that will be good for our style of play. We, obviously everything starts with us with defending and rebounding. And then we'll kind of go from there depending on who we have.
Now, Coach, I know you got 2 hours a week with your team, 2 hours a week with your team. So are you already putting in your defensive schemes and the workouts you're having, or you kind of playing it by ear, waiting to see until the summertime comes, everybody comes back from summer school and then try to do it then?
Yeah, we're just right now, we're just recruiting a lot. We're trying to put together a roster, and that cuts into our weekly time with the team, and we've only got maybe five or six guys that are returning. So we've had our work cut out for us on the recruiting trail right away. But we're definitely trying to figure out who we have and what their strengths are, particularly on the offensive end. We've got enough time to put together our defensive scheme and things like that. But we'll start more of that come June when everyone's here for summer school.
And, Coach, non-conference scheduling-wise, it has to be like a blessing now with being in the Missouri Valley. Now, if you're too good, nobody will play you. But if right now, people are all down. People play you right now. So going forward, you're going to have to do some two-for-one guarantee games like you did at Tennessee State, or is it more so you can pretty much get guys to come play you, or you can just play them on the road? How are you going to go about scheduling these games going forward now?
Well, you know, scheduling is hard at any level because, like you say, you have to play the right people. And I think everyone has to do what's best for their program. And sometimes that may not sit up well with other people. But what we're going to do here is we got to pick up kind of where the last staff left off and fulfill some games. We're going to try to play against the best, same thing that we did at Tennessee State while I was there. We played Kansas. We played Virginia. We played North Carolina State. We played Vanderbilt. We played Texas. We played Purdue. So we're not going to shower fast. I'm a head coach here at Missouri State. We'll still play those caliber people. And then hopefully on the side we'll be able to get more home games in the non-league by maybe having some things budgeted in that will allow for us to do some guaranteed game on our side too. So scheduling will always be a matrix. That and recruiting are the things that change every day. So we'll just keep really close tabs on it.
Okay, so Coach, what we typically do, JR and I, is talk to, which when they go to a new spot, we try to pick their brain about the good food spots that they're going into, you know, what they're leaving behind and what they're getting into. Now, from this move, you're moving from, you know, awesome barbecue to awesome barbecue, right? So you're gonna be able to pick, you know, like you're gonna have like the best of both worlds. You can actually solve a lot of the world's problems because people will say, you know, Memphis barbecue, Nashville, like this area of the country has the best barbecue. Now you're going to like the Missouri area or Kansas City barbecue, right? So you're gonna be able to tell people which is better, and you're gonna have, you know, all the data lined up for you, right?
Oh, absolutely, and that's my favorite lunch stop is a barbecue spot. I actually stopped at one here in town today, and it was really good. So, you know, Memphis, they do. I think they do the dry ribs down there.
Dry
rub ribs, and then up here is more of the sauce. So it's awesome. I think it's two different worlds, but they're both really good. So I'm gonna just stay right in the middle of that and say that both of them are really good.
Listen, they're two different worlds, Coach, but they're both delicious worlds, okay? Both worlds are delicious. I'm a junkie, man. I'm a barbecue junkie. Like, if I were in your shoes, I'd be pushing, like, you know, deuce and a half over here, easy. Because I'd be eating at those spots like lunch and dinner, bro.
That's awesome.
Yes, indeed. Now, Coach, now, I know you don't miss Jack's Barbecue. That's my favorite spot to go to, right by my house. So I'm going to ask you, I even some Jack's Barbecue. Now, when I come up there and see you guys play, because I'm surprised you show up there. I'm here. I'm surprised. Where should I go, man? Take y'all to where to get some good barbecue, man, for real. You know, well, I love this barbecue. That's some hot chicken.
I'm still learning my way around, too, so I can't throw out the recommendations yet. Today, I think I went to Crosstown Barbecue today, which is pretty good here in Springfield. Legendary spot. I think it's been around for almost 40 years or so. So that's the only one I can vouch for right now. That's the only one I've been to.
I'm gonna roll up there. Like, I'll be there with JR, man. I'll be there with JR. We'll hang out at the barbecue joint, wait for you, and after the game, you roll up and meet us, and we'll have already like sampled everything and be able to tell you what to get and save you
some
time.
Absolutely. Looking forward to it. Y'all come on, man.
So we also want to talk to you a little bit about the foundation too, the Rebound Foundation, and you know, find out what's going on with that. So where's everything stand with the foundation, and what can we expect down the line?
You know, it's going really well. My wife and I, we are obviously all in on it, and it'll be making its move here with us to Missouri, and we'll be starting some more of our fundraiser events. This summer is going to be a big summer for the foundation. We'll be putting together some new plans and potentially hiring some new board members. So we're really looking forward to the change and scenery with that. Nashville is fantastic for it. Nashville is such a giving city. I'm sure that we will figure out that Springfield is a giving city as well. Maybe not have as many people, but we may be able to have an opportunity where we have more hands on deck, you know, in a smaller community. So that thing really well. We're really close to actually breaking ground on our first remodeled home, which happened before October of this year. And man, we're really looking forward to it.
Well, Coach, you know, JRR and I still love to help and be a part of it in any way that we can. So if you need anything from us down the line for the foundation, we'll be happy to bring it to the listeners. And, you know, one of these days we might be able to put some boots on the ground and help you out with one of the projects. So we'll always, wherever you're at, we'll always be there to support the foundation.
Thanks, bud. We really appreciate that.
Hey, Coach, I say once again, man, I know it's a bit of a sweet, but I'm happy for you, man. I'm thankful that you're, you know, you're moving on up, man. Coach, we're 80s babies, man. We got to make it happen for the 80s babies, man. We'll make that for our clan, man. So we got to keep it going, buddy.
Well, hey, man, I know you'll do your part, so I better get mine done.
No doubt. You're the man, Coach. Hey, Coach, I'll talk to you on the show, man. Talk to you real soon, buddy.
Hey, I appreciate you guys. Y'all give me a call anytime.